Hello, beautiful soul. How do you feel today? But honestly, how do you feel today? I can't hear you, but please do answer to yourself. How do you feel today? And do you behave according to your emotions or are you trying to force things? Don't ever, ever try to force things if you don't feel like it. So if you are not feeling okay, first of all, know that is okay. You know, life can be very hard and life can throw at us very difficult situations, so it is okay to feel all those emotions that you feel. Just don't force or push things or pretend that you're okay if you don't feel okay. Yeah, that is something I would like to talk about today. Welcome to my new video. If you're new to my channel, my name is Irina, and I'm here hoping to help you, sharing my stories about life, giving you insights, and everything is based on my experience, my knowledge, and education, and many other things that I would like to share with you for free with intention to help. So if you find my work helpful and useful, please do subscribe to my channel because it is going to help me grow my channel and to maybe reach those who really need to hear this. And if you're not new to my channel, then thank you for being here and for sticking around. I really hope that you find my words useful because that's why I'm here. Well, this whole video is going to be more or less about honesty, but like I always like to say, everything starts with ourselves and self-love. If you know to love how to love yourself, if you are brutally honest with yourself, then you're going to be honest with others. And when I said before, if you don't feel okay, don't pretend that you're okay. By this, I'm not telling you go around and complain how bad you feel, or because that way you're going to convert into nothing but a victim. What I was saying is that you live your emotions and learn from them and grow through them. Grow through what you go through. That's what I was trying to say. The point is to accept all emotions and feelings, whether we talk about positive or negative emotions and feelings. There is nothing wrong with you if you feel sad or if you feel maybe depressed, or what matters is to not identify yourself through your feelings and through your emotions, and especially not through your thoughts, because you are not your thoughts. You know, thoughts are just visitors. Be a watcher of your thoughts, accept them and learn from them. Acceptance is always a key. Sometimes can be very hard, but it's the only way to go through life easy, to travel light easy. I really can't stress enough to be brutally honest with yourself, because that's the only true way to be honest with other people. You can't be honest with other people if you're not honest, if you're not being honest with yourself in the first place. For an instance, there are so many people who, for example, in messages, they will send you smiley or like they're laughing, you know, and they don't even laugh. So what makes you think if someone say to you, "I love you," that they truly love you? If they can lie about laughing, so what makes you think that they can't be lying about loving you? And I know that we all have experiences about these situations, and I really don't want you to focus on other people, especially not on other people's words. What I would like for you to focus on yourself always. You know, people can lie, and they lie a lot, but their energy never. So you should pay attention, speaking about other people, you should pay attention to their actions and to their energy, not only to words. Personally, words are at the bottom of the list that I am paying attention to when I speak to other people. I pay attention to so many other things, and words are like... And why? Why is that? Just because people are not being honest. Let's not forget, when I say people, we are also people. You and I, we are people. So check yourself, first of all. Are you being honest with yourself in the first place, then with others? What matters is when, not just that you are being honest with yourself, but to check your intentions. When you say something or when you do something, I think that I'm repeating this all over again, but intentions speak about who we are. Whatever you do in life, whatever you say, always think about your intentions, why you are doing that. And it will tell you so much about you. To simplify it even more, so you can understand me better, what I'm trying to say here, for an instance, I always like to use this example. There are three different people who will ask you the same question. For example, how are you? And one of them might truly, honestly be concerned about your health and how do you feel. Second one will only want to start a conversation, and that's the only way that they will start it, which is... And the third one can be really curious about life because they can spread a gossip about you. So as you can see, they all ask the same question, but their intention wasn't the same. That is why it is so important. That's how you know whether you are honest with yourself and with others, to always ask, question your intentions. This life would be so much easier if people were only honest with themselves in the first place. If only. But unfortunately, that's not the case. There are so many people who simply go through life sleeping, not being aware of anything, and they can't even understand these words because they're maybe not ready to hear. Luckily, there are those who will find these words very helpful, and it will be like a waking up call for them. And that's why I'm sharing my stories. So when you speak with other people, please, dear, remember, everyone can say I love you, but not everyone will mean that. So instead of focusing on words and trusting other people's words, like I said, pay attention to their actions, first of all. Believe it when you feel that, not when you hear that. Sometimes when I listen to people, especially those sugar-coated people, I'm not a fan of them at all. All I can hear when they are talking to me is like blah, 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 and I just want to finish the conversation, which I usually do, because there is no point of listening to those who simply are not being honest. So please do trust the actions, not their words. Simply, action always prove why words of so many people mean nothing. But as always, this also applies to you. So don't pay attention to what people say, pay attention to how they treat you, pay attention to their actions, and pay attention to energy. Energy simply never lies, you know. The point is that we often won't ignore those gut feelings because sometimes we want things to be different, let's say like that. But don't try to paint a new picture just because you wish so. You're going to lie to yourself, and I'm sure that all of us, we are capable of feeling other people's energy. It is just a point whether or not you will accept it, because the truth can be very hard, or you would like to continue to live in a lie. That's up to you. And quite shocking is that many people choose to live in a lie. They choose to ignore all signs that simply universe is sending them, or they ignore their gut feelings. They choose to continue living in lie just because they wish so, just because they think that is the easier way to live their life. And I can assure you that is not easier. That is only that living in a lie can only lead you to be a prisoner of yourself, your thoughts, and other people, and it can only lead you to one unhappy and not fulfilled life. And so it can't be easier, trust me. And there are those who simply close their heart and they are afraid of being honest with other people just because they've been hurt in their past. But dear, we all have been there. Somebody maybe hurt you, but you also, I'm sure, hurt someone, not intentionally, maybe. So there is no point of closing your heart. When you close your heart, you're letting your fear to guide you, and you don't want to let your fear guide you, because you want to live your life with love. You want that everything you do or say comes from the right place, from the place of love. And the other name for love is being honest. Not fear, but honest. When you are honest with yourself in the first place, oh my God, it is liberating, it is free. Honesty is like so liberating. I don't know why people are afraid of being honest. Yes, okay, somebody will also hurt you in the future, but this shouldn't stop you from being honest at all. You know, how other people treat us, it speaks about them, not about us. So be honest with yourself in the first place, and be honest with others. It doesn't matter. People are also afraid of being honest with other people because they're afraid of losing someone, which is again another issue, because you shouldn't be afraid of expressing yourself. You shouldn't be afraid whatever you feel. From within, you shouldn't suppress your feelings. You should always express how you feel honestly and with respect and with kindness. How other people will react, that shouldn't be your concern. Your concern is to express yourself in a respectful and kind way, of course, being honest. So keep in mind this as well. Lies are fear. Manipulation is fear. So if you lie other people, there is always some kind of fear behind, and it's up to every single person to see what is that fear, why they are afraid of expressing themselves, for example. So they choose to use lies, and that way they can't be happy, truly happy, because how can a lie bring you happiness? It can't. You know, honesty, no matter how difficult it is, can bring you so much joy, just because you don't want that burden on your chest. You don't want to spend your time. Everything you don't express honestly, our bodies are very smart, and you're going to, our bodies are like a storage, you know, they keep everything within. So those feelings, thoughts, emotions that you didn't express at the time, it will affect your health. So lies can't be good at all, you know, and apart you're going to hurt someone with your lies, and that's not good. That's not good at all. Everything, your foundation of any kind of relationship, and first of all with relationship with yourself, should be based on honesty. And if you build something on lies, I mean, you know the answer already. So like a conclusion, first of all, be honest with yourself and question your intentions. Question everything that you do. You will find out so much about yourself, things that you should improve or learn about yourself more. And it is like an endless journey, you know. I'm getting surprised with my decisions or thoughts sometimes. So it is an endless journey. I know that I'm in process and, you know, I'm going to learn so much about myself in the future. So you shouldn't be afraid of that. You should just only be honest with yourself. Honest with yourself and honest with others. Then, so far as concern other people's thoughts and how they treat you, don't trust, unfortunately, their words. Pay attention to energy, pay attention to their action, pay attention to how they treat you, and stay away from anything that feels toxic for you. Don't play with other people's emotions, especially when it comes to love. Don't say I love you if you don't really feel it. First of all, learn what love is, and then start loving yourself in the way I love you. That's why I'm here, that's why I share all of this, because I want for people to feel good about themselves in the first place, and it requires really to be honest with themselves. I want you to know that everything is a process, and you should always strive for progress, not perfection, and to go step by step. It's like peeling an onion. There's so many layers that you should be peeling off, and you know, take your time as much as needed, as long as you are honest with yourself. That's the only thing that matters, truly and honestly. So till my next video, I will leave you to think more about honesty. First of all, how honest are you being with yourself, and then with others? And do you surround yourself with people who are being honest with yourself or not? Are you being honest with them or not? Do you keep things within without saying them because you're afraid of losing them? Think about this more, please. And try to improve yourself. Don't be afraid of losing people as long as you stay true to yourself. It's a kind of win-win situation. Don't neglect this, because whenever you lose someone for being honest with yourself and with them in the first place, but you stay true to yourself, it's like a win-win situation. It can be hard sometimes because for many reasons, but it doesn't matter. Just be honest. And till my next video, I will continue to love you and to care about you. Bye.